Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the press conference at the FCCJ. My name is Teddy Jimbo. I co-chair the committee that organized the media events such as this one, and I'm also your moderator today. And we have three very distinguished guests today. I was asked to just briefly explain what the Hakamada Jiken, the Hakamada incident, is. So I will just give you kind of rundown of the event. But before so doing, let me just introduce speakers today. My immediate right is Katsuhiko Nishijima, and Nishijima-sensei. And he's, of course, the defense lawyer, the chief defense lawyer for the Iwao Hakamada, the currently officially still death convict. Next to Mr. Nishijima is Hideko Hakamada. She's a sister of Iwao Hakamada, of course. Very far left to you is the Mr. Hideyo Ogawa. He's also a defense lawyer. And our interpreter today is, as always, Mary Joyce. Okay. Just brief rundown of the incident. Hakamada incident is perhaps arguably the worst false accusation case in Japanese criminal history. One person was held over basically nearly 50 years for false accusation, for possibly a false accusation, or likely a false accusation. And the incident occurred in 1966 in Shimizu Prefecture, in Shizuoka, Shimizu City in Shizuoka Prefecture. And it was a case in which a family of four people, husband and wife, and two children, 17 years and 14 years old, were killed, and the house was set on fire, and all four people died. And shortly after the incident, actually about a month and a half after the incident, Iwao Hakamada, who was actually the employee of the company which was run by this family, and the company was a miso factory company, or miso producing company. But anyway, he was arrested in August in 1966, and then after, as you know, very famous draconian, very Spartan draconian, whichever you like to call it, the very harsh interrogation that goes on for 23 days. He confessed that he did it, and he was convicted based on his confession, and he was given a death sentence initially in 1968 by the district court, and his death sentence was finalized by Supreme Court in 1980. So he's been a death convict since 1980, but he's been held ever since his arrest, which was 1966. And what's this? Today is 2021. Well, anyway, he was actually released because his trial was briefly reopened in 2014. Thanks to a very tireless effort by his supporters and, of course, his sister and the defense lawyers team led by Mr. Nishijima, who's sitting right next to me. After repeated requests to reopen the case. Oh, but before going into that, I need to mention that he confessed once during the interrogation, when the court hearing opened, he denied his confession, and he said it was a forced confession due to a very high pressured interrogation. So, and he's been denying the accusation ever since. So that's very important. And repeated request from lawyers to reopen the case. The case was briefly reopened by the, based on the decision by the Shizuoka District Court in 2014. However, the High Court in Shizuoka denied the District Court's decision. And so that the case, which once was reopened, was closed again. And then just recently, I'm sure the lawyers were going to explain about this, but the Supreme Court, Japanese Supreme Court, rejected the High Court's decision that to reopen, or the High Court's decision to reject the defense lawyer's request to reopen the case. So that's where we stand. The case wasn't formally reopened yet. However, the High Court's decision not to reopen the case was rejected by the Supreme Court. So that's where we stand. And what we're waiting for is whether the High Court will reopen the case as basically directed by a Supreme Court. And then the case may be reopened. And then he needs to be acquitted in that reopened case. So we have a long way to go until Mr. Hakamada become a free man in genuine sense. And as you might see, we wanted to invite Mr. Hakamada today himself in person, but he is not well. And of course, after 40 some years of being held in a close, how this death convicts are treated. You know, they are not serving the term, by the way. You know, they are just waiting to be executed. So for 40 some years in jail. So he did that suffer a mental illness as well. But anyway, today instead of Mr. Hakamada, we have his sister, who's been supportive of him all along, and also two distinguished lawyers. And they will tell us where we stand and what the challenges are, and basically why is it taking this long. But anyway, that's why I said this is perhaps or arguably the worst false accusation case in Japanese criminal justice history. And he may be the victim of that. Which is, of course, yet to come. For the final result is yet to come because the court hearing hasn't been fully reopened. But anyway, please welcome Mr. Nishijima first. Nishijima is going to speak first. And then after that, we will show the video clip of Mr. Iwao Hakamada that people they brought to us today. So you'll be seeing the Mr. Hakamada's video after that, and then Hideko-san will speak, and Ogawa-san will speak, and then we go to Q&A. So please welcome first Mr. Nishijima, the Mr. Iwao Hakamada's defense lawyer.
Nishijima desu.
Good afternoon. As introduced, my name is Nishijima, the head of the defense team for Mr. Hakamada.
あらかじめペーパーを渡しておりまして、あるいは目を通されている方がいるかもしれませんが、一応このペーパーに従ってお話をしたいと思います。
So I have prepared some remarks today, which may be available later in a paper. I believe they're not actually in the room at the moment.
まず最初に、袴田事件は証拠の捏造ということで画期的な判断を得ているということで、それが第一の特徴だろうと思います。
And the first point to which I would like to speak is about the fact that there was a very new decision or recognition which was made that indeed evidence in the Hakamada case had been fabricated, likely.
事件が発生してから1年以上経った後、つまりもう裁判が始まってて、始まったどころか終盤の時にこの御殿の寄り紙噌タンクの底から発見されたというわけです。
More than one year after the initial incident, indeed, actually, when the trial was not only already underway, but when the trial was nearing the end of its proceedings, five pieces of clothing with bloodstains were found.
どういう状態で発見されたかと言いますと、 カラーで1枚で御殿の衣類を皆さんのお手元にないか。
And we have a photograph of the state of how the clothings were found. I think it has not made its way around to the floor, but we'll make sure that it will become available.
事前に渡しておいたんだけどな。じゃあ後でまたその点を解説。
So we will confirm those afterwards and share them later.
でこの御殿の衣類が袴田事件の有罪認定の中心的証拠とされてきました。
So these five pieces of clothing which you will soon see in the photograph were regarded as the central evidence for finding him guilty.
で死刑判決や第一次の再審請求の過程では御殿の衣類が長時間味噌漬けされたことは当然だとされてきましたが、その推定の根拠は何も示されていませんでした。
However, despite the fact that they were used in this way during the final judgment, which issued the death penalty, and during the first retrial request as well, at this time it was taken for granted that these five articles of clothing had been soaked in miso for a long period of time. However, no basis for such a presumption was provided.
これに対して第二次再審、今継続中なんですが、その静岡地裁決定が御殿の衣類が1年以上味噌に浸かっていたとするには不自然であり、
どうぞ。
相当期間経過した後味噌漬けされた可能性があると。そこでこのような証拠が事件後に作成されたとすれば捏造されたと考えるのが最も合理的であり、それについては捜査官の主導、つまり捜査官がもっぱら主犯って言いましょうかね、主導が疑われるとして弁護側の味噌漬け実験報告書を有力な新証拠と認めたわけです。
However, in response to this, in the second retrial, the Shizuoka District Court ruled that it was not natural to make an assumption that the five items of clothing had indeed been soaked in miso for more than 1 year. This also ruled that there had been a possibility that they were soaked in miso considerably later than the incident. And if such evidence had been created after the fact, then it was most reasonable to assume that the evidence had been fabricated. Therefore, the role or the initiative of the prosecutors, the investigators, was suspect. Therefore, the defense's report on the miso soaking experiment was therefore accepted as new evidence.
しかし、それを受けた東京高等裁判所は発見直後の後で皆さんのお手元に配れると思いますけれども、そのカラー写真は劣化しているとかですね、それからメイラード反応により黒褐色になるという専門家の意見を合理的な理由もなく否定して静岡地裁の開始決定を取り消して再審請求を棄却したのです。
However, after this, the Tokyo High Court rejected the opinions of experts that the color photographs, which you are now going to be distributed, which were taken immediately after the discovery, had either deteriorated or turned blackish brown due to the Maillard reaction. Therefore, they reversed the decision of the Shizuoka District Court and dismissed the request for a retrial.
今回の最高裁の差し戻し決定は結論としてメイラード反応その他の味噌漬けされた血液の色調の変化に影響を及ぼす原因についての専門的知見等を調査するなどした上でその結果を踏まえて御殿の衣類が昭和47年7月20日以前に1号タンクにいられて1年以上味噌漬けされていたとの事実に合理的疑いを差し挟むか否かについて判断させるために東京高等裁判所に差し戻すと、そういう決定にしたわけです。
And the recent Supreme Court's decision concludes,and this is a quote, after an investigation including expert knowledge on the Maillard reaction and other causes of change in the color tone of miso-soaked blood, The case is remanded to the Tokyo High Court to determine whether or not there is reasonable doubt about the fact that the five articles of clothing had been placed in tank number one before July 2019-66 and had been soaked in miso for more than 1 year.
コメントしておきますと、昭和41年7月20日というのは、味噌、最終的な味噌がタンクに入れられたという、その時期を指しております。
And here it refers to July 20. This was the last date in which the miso had been placed into the tank concerned.
要するに、この最高裁の差し戻し決定は、味噌漬け実験やメイラード反応に関して、心理不尽があると。十分な診療をしていないと、こういうことを言っているわけです。
And so, in short, or to summarize what this means, it means that the court found that there had been inadequate investigation of the miso soaking experiment and the Maillard reaction.
ここで若干日本の再審手続きについてコメントしておきたいと思います。
And I would like to add a comment about the system of the retrial procedures in Japan.
日本の再審手続きは、再審請求審で再審開始決定が確定した後、再審公判に移行して裁判のやり直しになる、二段階構造になっています。
So in Japan, after the decision to initiate a retrial becomes final and binding, the case is then transferred to a retrial court, and the trial will start therefore over again. So it has these dual layers within the process.
ところが再審開始決定には検察官の不服申し立てが認められて、また検察官が裁判に提出していない証拠の開示も義務付けられないなど、ご判定救済手続きとしては世界の趨勢から大きく遅れております。
However, it is considered that Japan's retrial procedures are indeed lagging far behind the rest of the world, as a procedure for redressing misjudgments in the reasons that prosecutors are permitted to appeal against the decision to start a retrial, and they are also not required to disclose unsubmitted evidence.
静岡地方裁判所の再審開始決定に対して検察官の不服申し立てをしたために、東京高等裁判所はそれを取り消すという、非常に不当な結果が招かれているわけです。
And so this is what led to the situation in this case where the prosecutors went against and said that there should not be a retrial for this, and then the district court in Shizuoka also went along and returned it in that way.
現在、裁判の進行はどうなっているかについて次に説明したいと思います。
I would next like to speak about the current situation of the procedures.
第1回の三者協議がつい先日開かれました。
Just the other day, the first round of the tripartite talks were held.
裁判長はあらかじめ弁護人が提出していた意見書や当日の主任弁護人私の補足発言を受けて、冒頭最高裁決定の先ほどの私が引用した部分を引用して、弁護人や検察官に主張立証の予定を尋ねました。
So the presiding judge during these three-party talks, first of all, quoted the conclusion which I just shared as well, this part of the Supreme Court's decision at the beginning of this session. This was in response to written opinions which had been submitted by me as the defense in advance and the supplementary remarks which were made. By myself, the Chief Defense Counsel, on the day of the session. The judge then asked both the defense and the prosecutors about the schedule of their arguments and proofs to be made.
検察官は第一弾としてメイラード反応について述べた弁護側の推薦した花田教授の花田意見書への反論を専門家に依頼して準備しているが、コロナや大学の移動時期もあり、7月いっぱいになると説明をしました。
So as the first part, the prosecutor responded to this by explaining that he had asked an expert to prepare a rebuttal to Hanada's opinion, the expert who had been recommended, Mr. Hanada, on the Maillard reaction. However, due to both COVID-19 and the transfer period of the universities, this would take until the end of July.
弁護側は強く反発して、2、3ヶ月もあれば十分だし、赤みが残るということについての説明が必要なのだから、 それについて立証はどうなっているのかと迫りました。
The defense strongly objected to this and pressed, first of all, that 2 to 3 months should be sufficient for this process, and also pressed that the prosecution must provide an explanation for the red color remaining on the items.
裁判長は弁護人のこの主張に同調して、赤みが残る可能性があることについて触れてもらわなければならないと述べました。
The presiding judge concurred with this argument of the defense and stated that the possibility of this red color must be referred to.
そして弁護人の求めに応じて裁判長は、検察官が開示していない未開示証拠の少なくともリスト、証拠のリストだけでも開示をしたらどうかということを検察官に勧告しました。
And in addition, at the request of the defense counsel, the presiding judge made the suggestion that the prosecutor should disclose at least the list of evidence which had as yet not been disclosed or submitted.
その時弁護側は専門家にも当たっているが、衣類や血痕を味噌につけるということについての専門家はいないので、いろんな条件を変えて味噌漬けの追加実験を弁護側でやっているということを報告しました。そして検察官は実験しているかやその準備中かも明らかにしませんでした。
And in addition to this, the defense reported that they had contacted or we had contacted various experts. However, as there are no people who are experts on clothing and bloodstains which have been soaked in miso, they have therefore been conducting additional experiments on this under various different altered conditions. The prosecution, in response to this, did not reveal whether they themselves were conducting experiments or making preparations to do so.
以上の現状を踏まえて、今後我々はどういう戦いに臨もうとしているのかについて何点かを提示したいと思います。
So that shows you where the current status or the current situation of the discussions, the legal proceedings are. Based upon that, I would like to share with you our next steps or what we see as the next things we will be working towards within this fight.
まず第一に検察官のペースで審理が長期化すること、特に実験を理由にした長期化は絶対に阻止するということであります。
First of all, we are wanting to make sure that we certainly ensure that the proceedings are not protracted just along the pace of the prosecutors, and particularly that they will not be prolonged for the reason of such experiments.
で、2番目に科学的あるいは科学、化け学ですね、科学の知見を戦わせる論争は避けると、つまりよく言う空中戦は避けるということです。
And next, we want to ensure that disputes about scientific or chemical findings, you know, these kind of abstract discussions just on that are avoided.
3番目に、弁護側の実験結果を適当な時期に裁判所に明らかにして、審理の促進を促すことにしたいと思っています。
Third, we plan to facilitate our process or progress in the trial by revealing results of the defense's experiments to the court at an appropriate time.
4番目にその他の論点、これ大事なことですけども、最高裁決定が信用性を否定した DNA に関する本田鑑定の補強立証を早めに行いたいと思っています。
And fourth, in regards to other issues, and this is also an important point, we want to ensure to promptly reinforce the proof of the DNA test, or which is known as the Honda test, which the Supreme Court decision rejected as being credible.
最後に、最高裁決定中に2人の反対意見があることはご存知だと思います。つまり、差し戻さないでこの場で再審開始にするべきだという2人の有力な意見が決定に述べられているわけ。こういうことは前例のないことですけれども、この反対意見を十分活用して、弁護団と支援者が一体となって、早期決着の運動を盛り上げていきたいと思っております。
And the fifth and final point, you may be aware that there were also dissenting opinions within the judges of the Supreme Court. These two dissenting opinions were actually very strong opinions, saying that rather than just returning it to the district court, it should be able to skip that step and indeed go straight into the retrial. This is something which is unprecedented. Therefore, we want to make sure to utilize these two dissenting opinions in the Supreme Court's decision as much as possible to boost the movement for an early settlement of the case, with both the defense team and supporters working together.
カラー写真をお手元に配布されて、まだ。
The photographs, はい、have they been distributed now?
皆さん行ってますか？
今行ってるみたいですね。はい。
必要だったらこれを示した上で。
あ、そうですね。はい。五点の緩いっていうのは、上半身は一番上にスポーツシャツ、長袖です。
And the first photograph, as you can see, it's a long-sleeved sports shirt.
で、その右側にある半袖シャツがこれです。
And the short-sleeved shirt to the right, you can see here.
で、下が、一番下がブリーフ、緑色のブリーフ。
And you can see underneath there is the green colored underwear or briefs.
その上に、捨ててこ。これは皆さん捨ててこは日本だけの特殊なあれかな。汗を取る下着です。
And you can see the long underwear underneath, which are called steteko. It's perhaps a particular Japanese kind of underwear, which is used for soaking up sweat and so on.
ズボンの裏側です。
And the very bottom photograph is the inside of the trousers, which have been turned inside out.
これもあの白いのが 裏生地がついてるわけ。ズボンのパンツの下に。
So the trousers have an inner lining, which is the white clothing.
この血液の付着具合を見ていただくと分かりますけれども、まず一番問題になっているのはこの半袖の下着です。
And so the most significant issue you can see here is the half-length underwear.
この右肩の部分のところに従来はまだ死刑判決が確定するまでは DNA ということは論争されていなかったので血液型が B 型だということでこれは袴田の血液型だということで重視されてきましたけどそれに DNA 鑑定をしたところそうではないということを本田鑑定が示してくれたわけです。
And so in regards to this, actually at the time of the original trial in the 60s, DNA testing was not used or was not available at that time. Therefore, the blood which you can see on the right side of this underwear, because it was the B-type blood, it was assumed within the trial that it was the blood of Mr. Hakamata. However, DNA testing, which is what is known as the Honda test, which came out later on, showed that it was not actually the DNA belonging to Mr. Hakamata.
この5点の入れについては DNA だけが問題になっていますけれども血液の付着具合もあまりにも不自然だということがたくさんあります例えばこの捨ててこの血液の方がたくさん付着しててその上に履いているパンツの方の血液がズボンの裏生地でもほとんどっていうか捨ててこに比べるとわずかな血液しかついてないつまりこれは確定判決はどうしてどう弁明したかというと犯行の途中で履き替えたんだというそんな信じられないようなことで有罪判決を擁護しているわけですね。
And so it is only the DNA issue which had been taken up as an issue in regards to the clothing, but there are also many other factors which are indeed very suspicious in regards to this clothing as well. Looking at, for example, the amount and also the location on the items of the blood as well. If we take the long underwear, which was the so-called steteko in Japanese, we can see that there is a significant amount of blood on these, particularly in comparison to the trousers, which he was supposedly wearing on top of those, which have far less blood on the outer layer as well. What was given as the reason for this in the initial court proceedings was they said that he changed what he was wearing during the crime, during the incident. However, this is an explanation which is indeed, you know, very difficult to believe.
今中心的争点になっているのはこのような血液の付着状況は長期間1年以上使ってたことを示すのかそれとも発見直前に何者かが血液をつけて味噌だるに放り込んだっていうか そういう捏造なのかということが中心的争点になっているわけです。
And so these items which were used as the central piece of evidence in finding Mr. Hakamata guilty, first of all looking at the situation of blood on the items, but also the fact that they are said to have been left soaking in miso for a very long period of time, indeed for more than one year. Whether that is indeed actually the case of what happened, or whether they were planted by someone immediately before their discovery, which would indicate that they have indeed been fabricated.
この御殿の色に関する説明について後で小川弁護士の方から加えて説明してもらえるかもしれません。
And so this is indeed one of the points which will be a central part of discussion or debate within the upcoming procedures as well. And Mr. Ogawa may have some more to add in
about
that later.
私の、メッセージはこれでおしまいになります。
And that's the conclusion of my message. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Nishijima.Okay, so we're going to go to Ms. Hideko Hakamada, but as I explained, there are going to be a video of Mr. Iwao Hakamada. That's about a minute, about 2 minutes long. So we're going to put it on the screen here, and also we'll be airing the same video on the live streaming as well. So whenever you're ready, どうですか?Okay, so you see just recent Iwao Hakamada, Mr. Iwao Hakamada's footage, and of course he suffers the so-called Ganser syndrome, which is sort of an imprisoned reaction, and also he suffers diabetes as well, so his health is ailing very rapidly, and that's one of the reasons that this court process need to hurry. Anyway, we'd like to present you the Hideko Hakamada, the older sister of Iwao Hakamada. Hideko-san, じゃあよろしくお願いします。
Hakamada でございます。いろいろお世話になっております。私たちの裁判は長くて本当に50年もう55年になります。50年かかってやっと明かりが見えてきたという感じでございます。12月23日の最高裁の高裁の規約というか差し戻しをされた時には本当に私は喜んでおりました。 岩尾にもそのことを言いましたら、なんか再審は終わったと、そう言っておりました。
Good afternoon. My name is Hakamata. Thank you very much for the opportunity today. Our proceedings, our trial and so on, our struggle has been going on now for a very long time, indeed 50, almost 55 years. However, now that 50 years have passed, I finally feel that I am starting to see some kind of light. The decision on December 23 of the Supreme Court to remand back to the High Court again was something which I was truly very overjoyed to hear as well. When I told Iwao about this decision that was being made, it felt almost as if the retrial itself was finished.
12月23日以降、Iwao は今画面でご覧になった通りの元気にしております。私は岩尾が元気で、頑張ってくれるっていうことよりも、再審請求が早く、再審請求になるといいと思っておりますが、なかなか国のやることでそうも参りません。
And since that time, since December 23, as you have just seen on the video as well, Iwao is staying healthy. For me, of course, for him just to be healthy, even if he's not necessarily working hard towards something, but him being there and having his health means everything to me. Of course, we are hoping that our request for a retrial will be granted. However, in the manner in which the government does these kind of things, it's not necessarily moving forward yet.
この頃では岩尾は毎日ドライブに行ったりしております。前は浜松の町を歩いておりましたが、12月23日以後はドライブに行くようになりました。それで見守り隊というものがあって、その方たちと一緒にドライブに1週間の半分ぐらいは行っております。で、あとの一週間の半分は街歩きをしております。
Recently, since the decision on December 23rd has been going for drives around the area or having people taking him for drives. Before, he would be walking every day around the city of Hamamatsu or patrolling, as you could see in the photograph, the video. Now, his supporters are taking him for drives perhaps half of the week, and it is the other half of the days of the week where he is walking or patrolling around the city.
Iwao の無実はもうじき証明されます。必ず証明されると思っております。弁護士先生が一生懸命頑張ってくださるし、支援者ももう本当に休みも何もなく一生懸命実行をしております。私は岩尾の無実が証明されることは間もなくだと思っております。これからも
どうぞいいですよ、どうぞどうぞ。Iwao's innocence will indeed soon be proven. I am certain that this will be the case. The lawyers are doing all that they can, and supporters also working, making all efforts every day, unceasingly, without rest. I am certain that his innocence is soon to be proven.
50年戦ってきましたが、やっと私は、なんか明かりが見えてきたと思って、もうとても喜んでおります。
After 50 years of fighting, I feel that I am finally able to see some light. This is something which makes me greatly happy.
一日も早い再審開始を待ち望んでおります。長い裁判で皆様にも大変ご迷惑をかけております。今後ともにどうぞご支援を賜りたいと思います。ありがとうございました。
I am indeed hoping that the retrial will start again as soon as possible, even one day sooner. I am sure that in this long period of the struggle of the trial, we have also caused great inconvenience to many people as well. But I would like to count on you for your continued support from now as well. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Hakamada-san. Okay, so let's go to... Mr. Ogawa, also another member of our defense lawyers team. Thank you. お願いします。
私は静岡県弁護士会の小川です。弁護団の事務局長をしております。
Good afternoon. My name is Ogawa. I am from the Lawyers Association in Shizuoka, and I'm also the Secretary General of the Legal Team.
最高裁は今回の決定で袴田事件が間違ってた誤判であるということを認めました。私はこれが一番言いたいことです。
So with this recent decision, the Supreme Court has acknowledged that the Hakamata case was indeed a miscarriage of justice or a misjudgment. This is the main point which I would like to convey.
これまで日本では1980年代に再審で無罪となった免田、斉田川、松山、島田の4事件が死刑事件の誤判とされてきました。
Until now, there have been four death penalty cases in Japan that were acquitted after retrial in the 1980s, namely the Menda, Saitagawa, Matsuyama, and Shimada cases, which are considered to have been wrong convictions.
今回の最高裁の決定というのは、再審開始はしません、認めてくれませんでしたけれども、袴田事件が間違ってた誤判であるということを認めたという点では画期的な判断であったというふうに考えています。
So although the recent Supreme Court decision did not actually initiate a retrial, I believe that it was a landmark decision in that it recognized that the Hakamata case had been misjudged.
この決定で袴田事件が我が国の5件目の死刑事件の誤判事件だということになったということです。
So I believe that with this decision, the Hakamata case has indeed become the fifth death penalty case in Japan to have been declared as having been based on a wrong judgment.
それを説明します。最高裁はこの決定文でははっきりと言葉に出してはいません。
So to explain a little bit further, the Supreme Court did not necessarily say this directly in so many specific words in its verdict.
しかし、この事件はまず一番重要な争点は、今重要な争点になっているのは、5点の衣類が事件直後に入れられたのか、発見直前に入れられたのか、どちらかということです。
However, the most important fact which is now being discussed is whether the clothing items which were indeed used as essential evidence were placed in the tank just before the discovery or if they had already been there since just after the incident.
最高裁は血液、五点の衣類についている血液の色だけでいつ入れられたかが判断できるんだというふうに言っています。
And the Supreme Court said that just the color of the blood on these items was sufficient to determine that the items had been put in the tank just before the discovery.
これは常識的なことでもありますし、我々が何度も実験したことなんですが、1年2ヶ月も血液が味噌についていれば、使っていれば真っ黒になります。
And this is something which, first of all, is common sense, but which has been proven many times in our multiple experiments, which have been held as well, is that if clothing which has blood on it is left to soak in miso for 1 year and 2 months, the color of that blood will turn to close to black.
それで、まあ、最高裁は色だけで判断できるっていうのは、他にこの五点の衣類がいつ入れられたか判断できる証拠は何もないから、色だけで、血液の色だけで判断できるというふうに言ったわけです。
And the reason that the Supreme Court said that the color of the blood was enough to determine that the items had been placed in the tank just before the discovery is that there is absolutely no evidence showing at all anything otherwise or showing that they were indeed put in the tank just after the incident.
確定判決、これまでの判決というのは、何にもその味噌を、この五点の衣類がいられた時期についての証拠が何もないのに、事件直後に入れられた犯行着衣だというふうに判断してたと、そういうことなんです。それを最高裁は認めたということです。
And so the previous judgments in this case had all judged that the clothing had been put in the tank just after the incidentsDespite the fact that there had been no evidence at all submitted towards this fact, they just made this assumption that the clothing was what had been worn when the crime had been made. However, the Supreme Court stated that indeed this was not the case and there was this problem that there had been no evidence submitted before.
最高裁は今回の決定の中で少数意見ですけれども、ちょっと面倒くさい言葉で恐縮ですけれども、確定判決および第一次再審請求審では御殿の入りが長期間みそ漬けにされたことは当然視されたが、かかる推定の明確な根拠は示されなかったと書いています。
So this time in the judgment, the verdict of the Supreme Court, although it was within the minority opinion, and this is, it's somewhat of a roundabout way of saying it, but to quote, in the final judgment and the first retrial request, it was taken for granted that the five articles of clothing had been soaked for a long period of time. However, no clear basis for this presumption was shown.
これは少数意見が書いているところですけれども、事実を述べているだけですから、多数意見も含めた最高裁の全員の一致した認識だということです。
So although this text was included within the minority opinion, because it is just a statement of fact, it means that this was the unanimous understanding of all of the judges, including the majority opinion.
ここで最高裁は確定判決が明確な根拠もないのに袴田さんを犯人としたと言っているわけですから、誤判であるというふうに宣言したというふうに理解できます。
So because this states that Mr. Hakamata was made to be the criminal in the final judgment without any clear evidence, then this indeed indicates or declares that the Supreme Court did indeed declare that the initial final judgment of the case had been a misjudgment.
確定判決が誤判であるというにもかかわらず、最高裁が再審開始を認めなかったのは、ちょっと法律制度にあります。要するに、私たちが提出した新証拠である味噌漬け実験報告書が、残念ながら刑事訴訟法の435条6号ですけれども、明白な新証拠であるとは言えないと判断したということです。
And so the only reason that the Supreme Court did not allow the retrial or did not order the retrial to begin, despite the fact that the final judgment was found to have been erroneous, is based on legal proceedings, in that it judged that the new evidence which we submitted, including the report on the miso soaking experiments, was not considered as what is known as obvious new evidence under Article 435, Item 6 of the Code of Criminal Procedure.
しかし最高裁が今の段階でこの事件が誤判であると認めたことの意義はとっても大きいことだと思います。
However, I believe that it is indeed very significant that the Supreme Court has recognized at this stage that the case was a misjudgment initially.
その意義は私が思うところ4つあります。
And there are four reasons for this.
第一に、最高裁が誤判であると認めたんですから、日本の制度では下級審、東京高裁も含めてですけれども、下級審はその判断に従わなければなりません。
The first is that since the Supreme Court has ruled that there was a misjudgment under Japan's legal system, the lower courts, which includes the Tokyo High Court, must also follow this decision.
第二に、誤判であるわけですから、再審の要件が今はないんですけれども、早く再審を認めて無罪にしなければならないのは当然のことです。
And secondly, although the legal conditions were not in place at that point, the retrial, because it was indeed a misjudgment, the retrial must be granted as soon as possible and the accused must be found not guilty.
第3に、袴田さんは静岡地裁の決定で釈放されていますが、この釈放を取り消すということはもう許されないということです。
The third is that Mr. Hakamata was released from prison on parole after the Shizuoka District Court made its decision to launch the retrial. But this decision means that his release must not be allowed to be revoked.
で最後に第4に、袴田さんはこの誤判によって死刑囚として48年間拘束されていたため、今でもさっきビデオをご覧になった通り、ひどい妄想の状態が続いていますが、これについて国は責任を負わなくてはいけないということだと思います。
And fourth, after having spent 48 years on death row, because of this erroneous decision, as you have seen in the video, Mr. Hakamata continues to be often in a state of severe delusion, and this is something for which the government must take responsibility.
以上です。
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ogawa. So we're going to go to Q&A here. Let's try to pick up questions from the floor first. Then I have some questions coming in online. So if time allows, I go to that. So let's see some hands.
では質疑応答になります。
及川君、どうぞ。
まずは会場からの質問、その後オンラインからの質問になります。
普段支店の及川と申します。袴田さんの事件については、私、保坂信人現世田谷区長とずっと付き合いがあって、まあ、お話を伺ってて、2003年3月10日の面会記録も読みましたし、あと、釈放されたときに区長室で保坂信人さんにインタビューをし、そして2014年11月15日、青山学院大学で袴田巌さんのお話も伺いました。そこでお伺いしたんですが、今、先生からも妄想という言葉がありましたけども、抗菌の医療者なのか、夢の中で生きているというような状態が、面会記録など、あるいは青山学院でのイベントのお話を伺う限り続いていらっしゃったと思うのですが、今、それは釈放されて7年で、状況は少し改善されたのかと、もし改善されたとしたら、どういう点なのかということが1点と、あと、ボクシングでメダルをもらった時のシーンを見ると、まあ、身体記憶は残っていらっしゃるのかなと、まあ、ピースをしてらっしゃったと、まあ、そういったお話も伺えればと思います。
So to summarize the question in English, in different occasions, for example, minutes of visitations while he was still in prison or talks which is given afterwards being released as well. We heard, and as was Mr. Ogawa mentioned as well, Mr. Hakamata is in somewhat of a state of delusion, sometimes in a dream world somewhat. I wonder if we could ask what his current situation is after 7 years since being released, if there is a kind of improvement in his situation, and if so, on what particular points. And the second point, also looking at the different scenes, for example, when he was receiving a medal for boxing, as he was a former boxer and so on. And also in the video, it does seem that he does have some kind of physical strength still. I wonder if we could ask a little bit about that scene and his current situation for that also.
どなたが、どなたがありますか？岩
尾のことですが、当初3月27日に釈放された時は、釈放されたって言って出てきて、もう完全に解放されたと思っていたんですね。でそれで私たちはちょっと医者に見せた方がいいと思ってしばらく医者に病院へ入院させました。精神科へ。そうすると抗菌症の加減といいますか、なんて言いますか、癖といいますか、長年の習慣といいますか、夜電気をね、看護師さんが消すと、岩尾が起きて電気をつけて回ると、それを何度もやったって。それからトイレ入りますね。そうするとトイレのノブをで入る時もきれいに拭いて、ティッシュペーパーで出る時もきれいに拭くと、そういう状況でございます。
So first of all, at the first initial time when he was released from prison, he believed that he had been completely released or fully released at that time as well, was his sort of understanding of the situation. We wanted to make sure that he could receive medical help or support as well, so we decided to have him hospitalized within a psychiatric hospital for some time as well to have him observed and his situation to be checked as well, particularly looking at the different habits, shall we say, or different behaviors that he developed after being kept in detention for such a long period of time. For example, when the nurse would go around the hospital in the evening to turn out all the lights, he would get up and then go around to turn them all back on again. Or also when going into the bathroom, he would, wash the doorknobs and so on with tissue paper, both on the way in and the way out as well. There are several different particular behaviors or habits which he developed from his time in detention.
So then, その後ね、浜松へ帰って、2ヶ月いたんですが、東京の病院には。からその後1ヶ月浜松の精神科の病院にいました。
So first of all, he spent 2 months in a hospital in Tokyo and then 1 month in a hospital in Hamamatsu, where we live.
その時に、まあ、自分は富士山を見に行くって言って連れ出したもんですから、入院するのは心外だと見えて、そんな約束じゃないって言って少しごねたんです。だけど私のうちにね、いずれは来るけど、私のうちは今準備してるで、しばらくね、それまで待ってここで養生してって言って入院させました。
So initially when he was released, he thought it was also to be coming home as well. Therefore, he saw that being put in hospital, he saw this somewhat as a violation. He was not necessarily happy and was sort of arguing against that. However, I explained to him, well, I'm preparing my house now for you to come home. We're preparing to welcome you back. So just wait here, rest here for a while we get things ready.
その時に朝ね、翌日の朝、何が何だかわからんって言うんです。だから何にもわからなくていいよ、だからまあしばらく静かにしてって言って入院させて、その頃は大変、まあ、まともだと思ったんです、私は。
And the next morning he said to me that, well, he didn't know what was what. He didn't know where he was or what was happening. But I said to him, you know, that's okay. Just stay here, rest and be quiet. And then during the months that he spent in hospital, he did spend them in this very calm way. So I really thought that his situation was indeed quite good.
それが家へ帰ってくると、まあ、絵がご覧になった方はお分かりのように、部屋の中を10時間も歩き回る。
However, after coming home, and some of you may have seen a film about his situation as well, during the initial days at home, he would spend 10 hours every day just pacing, walking in the rooms at home.
それから外へ一歩も出ない。
He would not even step one step outside of the home.
それからお客さんが来ると、面会謝絶ですってお断りする男性、特に男性には。
And when people would come to visit him, he would say, you know, I'm refusing any visitors, especially any male visitors.
で、午前中はやっぱりおかしいんです。突拍子もないことを言うんです。だけど私は、まあともかく岩尾の言う通りに、初めはね、そんなこと言うもんじゃないとか言って叱りましたがね、あ、これは叱ってもしょうがないと思いましてね、そう、じゃあね、こうしようねとかって言ってね、まあ、突拍子もないこと言うんですよ。そういうことを言っても受け入れてますの。
And particularly during the mornings was when he was most, well, not well, when he was most in this kind of state as well. At first, in the days when he came back home, I would, you know, tell him off, try to correct him, try to, you know, say against what he was saying and so on. But I realized that there was also not much purpose in doing that as well. So I started to, you know, nod or say, okay, go along with what it was he was saying, and I'm accepting, you know, how the state of how he is.
So the one thing. 半年間ぐらいぶっ続けで同じことをする。例えばご飯食べるときにラーメン食べますでしょ、毎日ラーメンを半年ぐらい続けて食べるんです。
And he would also continue to do the same thing over and over again for a period of 6 months. For example, when we would think or when to have a meal, he would insist on having ramen for every meal, you know, for the 6 months. He would just be eating ramen for that whole period.
そこから今街歩きしてますが、これも後遺症の加減だと思っております。私は徘徊をしているのだと思います。
And he is now, as you could see, you know, walking around the town, walking around and so on. But I also see that this is sort of a legacy or one of the remaining after effects of his very long time having been imprisoned.
それで内科の医者にもねかかりましたのでね、内科の医者さんには月に2回来ていただいております。
And as well as the psychological aspects, we are also having him seen by a medical doctor 2 times a month as well.
そのお医者さんも女性でなければやっぱりダメなんです。
And he only accepts this if the doctor is a woman, actually.
それと川村さんでなくて、刑務所にいたか監視の元監視の方が、もう今は辞めてる方が面会に来て、岩尾に監視の方ですよって言ったら、そそくさともうご飯も食べないで外へ出かけるんです、逃げるように。
And actually, people who had been the former guards within the prison came to visit him as well. And when he heard about that as well, he would immediately, you know, refuse to eat and just leave the house straight away, almost as if trying to escape from the guards in that sense.
ことほどさようにすべからく拘禁症といいますか刑務所の、まあ、習慣というものが身についておりますのでまだまだ治ったとは言いかねます。
And so these kind of, aspects of how he's living after having been living in confinement within the prison for so long, these different habits and behaviors are so much ingrained within him that I don't think it's possible to say that he has, you know, improved or he has, you know, this has been redressed, shall we say.
Did this prison reaction getting any better after he was released about 7 years ago, or is it getting worse?
この拘禁症状は岩尾さんが釈放されてから、良くなっているのかあるいはむしろ悪くなっているのかという点ではいかがでしょうか。
まあ、ある部分では、まあ、健康的になってはいるんですが表情なんかはたくさん出てきておりまして初めはもうニコリともしないでいたのをこの頃は笑ったりあくびもしたりするんです。はじめはあくびもしないし、寝るにも直立そう寝ておりましたの。まあ拘置所の習慣でしょうね。で、まあ言ってみれば、そういう習慣というものが少しずつ抜けてきていると、こういう状況です。
So in some ways, I think he has become more healthy during the period. One example is that his facial expressions, when he first came out, you know, he wouldn't ever, you know, even smile or even yawn. However, now he is able to sometimes be smiling or laughing or yawning. So little by little, we are seeing in these very small ways some of the habits from his long period of imprisonment are somehow being taken or stopping.
はい、ありがとうございます。OK、カニさんどうぞ。
ラジオフランスの西村と申します。弁護士さんに質問させていただきます。どう考えても国から、赤羽岩尾さんに対してあまりにも非人道的な扱いが続いていると言っても過言ではない。国際法の観点から問題もあると考えられますが、再審が、まあ、直ちに決定されるために、あるいは事件を終わらせるために、国際舞台で何か法的手続きが可能ではないでしょうか。
I have a question for the legal team. Looking at the treatment of Hakamata Iwao by the government, I think it's no exaggeration to say that it's extremely inhumane conditions continuing for a very long period of time, and this is something which could be considered an issue under international law as well. I would like to ask if there are any plans for or any legal steps which could be taken on the international stage, whether it's looking towards bringing about the retrial at an early stage or bringing an end to this situation.
私から人権規約に日本も加わってますけれども国内の救済規定がなくなったときには提訴できるという仕組みになってて一応再審手続きが日本の場合には曲がりなりにも存在するものですからそこの救済を今やっているということで海外というか国際機関に提訴するということはおそらく門前払いになるんではないかと思います。で、日本の再審請求がいかに不十分であっても一応建前上は救済されるということになっているのでそこで十分戦う余地が残されているということで僕らは今頑張っているところです。
So Japan is, of course, a party to treaties in relation to human rights. However, it's considered that you can only appeal to these international stages once all domestic measures or means for redressing the situation have been exhausted or have been gone through as well. Because Japan, although there are insufficiencies to the system, it does have this process for the retrial and so on within Japan. So it's considered within the international law as well that going through these in the first stage is what is necessary. So I think at this stage, if we were to try and submit it to international bodies and so on, it would not be accepted at this stage because it would be seen that there are still the domestic procedures to be gone through. So although there are these problems with the Japanese system, the system does still exist here and there is still the room for the retrial, so that is the place where we are now conducting our fight.
Okay, there's another hand. Dozo.
Okay. The speakers agreed to stay a little bit longer, though the scheduled time has passed, so we're gonna extend it a little bit. Go ahead, please.
Journalist Awano to moshimasu. Ogawa-sensei iwai wa 決してお若くないと思うんですけど、本当にご苦労様でありがとうございました。一つ質問いたします。2014年の村山裁判長の最新決定は素晴らしい決定だったと思ってるんですけど、最新開始決定で明確に捏造であると、フレームアップであるということを言ったのは異例だと思います。で、これが逆にですね、単なる誤認逮捕であれば、検察も白旗を上げて、ごめんなさいと。で済むということはないかもしれないんですけど、捏造ということだけは認められないということで、逆に徹底抗戦してくる、長期化してしまうとか、そういうことを僕ちょっと心配するんですけど、そのあたりはいかがでしょうか。
So I would like to ask a question. First of all, I believe that the judgment of Judge Murayama in 2014 was indeed excellent, and looking at the fact that it made clear that this was, you know, framing or a fabrication. If it was the case that it was just a wrongful arrest or a wrongful prosecution, then perhaps the prosecutors may say sorry, and then this could be brought to an end. However, the fact that it's clearly talking about a fabrication perhaps is something that will mean that the prosecutors will come strongly against this to fight against this as well, which could lead to also a prolonging of the situation as well. I would like to ask for a comment about that.
この事件は、誤点の衣類だけでなくて他の証拠もたくさん本当に捜査機関の捏造の証拠がいっぱいある事件だというふうに考えています。
So I believe that this case, the items, the evidence which has been fabricated by the investigators is not limited to only these five pieces of clothing, but actually there are many other pieces of evidence which were also fabricated.
ですからこの捏造の問題を避けてはこの事件を議論することはできないということなんです。
Which means that it is impossible to be discussing or looking at this particular case while avoiding or trying to go around the discussion of the issue of fabrication.
で、今回の最高裁も誤点の衣類がこういつ入れられたかというのは事件直後であれば犯人だけれども発見直前であれば捏造の可能性があると、やっぱり捏造の問題を正面から最高裁も、取り上げたことで今回の議論になっているということです。
And particularly also looking at the statement which was made by the Supreme Court recently as well, it says clearly when discussing about when these five pieces of clothing were put in the miso tank, if it was just after the incident, then that would mean that it was, you know, things which belonged to the criminal. However, if they were placed in the tank immediately prior to the discovery, then that does mean that they were, or there's a possibility of them having been fabricated. So this statement made by the Supreme Court very much will head on talks about this fabrication issue as well.
ですからこういう方向でもう間もなく解決ができると思ってます。
Which is why we believe that through this direction is how we will be able to resolve this issue.
ありがとうございます。
Thank you very much.
Just a little follow up on that question about the fabrication about evidence done by police or the prosecutors. There are many cases in which I have done reporting.In which the court says that the when they rule out the possibility of a publication of evidence, the court often says there's no reason or there's no motivation by the investigator or the police or the prosecutors to fabricate the evidence, so that it is unlikely that such a thing happened. And what's your assessment of that assessment, or if there is actually a motivation or the reason for the prosecutors or even the police to fabricate the evidence. What do you think it is? すいません、これまで取材したケースでも証拠の捏造が疑われる場合にですね、いくつかの判決などで裁判官がその捜査官がそもそも証拠を捏造する動機がないというようなことをですね、平気で言うケースをたくさん自分自身に取材してきているんですね。そこで今回のケースで分かったことというのも含めて特に外国の記者たちに説明するという意味も含めてですね、そのポリス、警察や検察がそもそも今おっしゃったように捏造をそのしなければならない理由あるいはその動機が何なのか、ということを最後に先生方に伺いますでしょうか。お願いします。
いいですか。いろいろな理由があると思いますが、この事件はこれは我々 の, 本来の仕事ではないんですけれども、この事件は警察が捏造を証拠を捏造したというのはおそらく真犯人と警察が何らかの関係があった、あるいは警察が真犯人を知っててそれを擁護しようとした、そういうところから始まったものだと思います。
There are various reasons which could be considered, and you know, this is not necessarily our particular role or our job, but I think in this case, it is likely that the reason that the police fabricated the evidence was that there was some kind of relationship between the real criminal, the real perpetrator, and the police. Or perhaps that the police knew who the perpetrator was, but were covering up or protecting them for some reason.
それは例えば事件発生からもう4日後に袴田さんのパジャマを押収して、それには目に見える血痕なんて何もなかったのに、血染めのシャツ発見というですね、そういう報道を警察はさせているというようなことから、もう最初からもう袴田さんに向けて警察は動いてたということは明らかだと思います。
An example of this is just 4 days after the crime, the police confiscated the pajamas of Mr. Hakamata. There was absolutely no visible blood at all on these items which were confiscated. However, the police reported to the media that a shirt covered in blood stains was found. So we could see even from this very initial stage, the days after, that these statements or looking about bringing about this suspicion, bringing people to believe that Mr. Hakamata was the perpetrator.
ただ、もう本当にこう真犯人に近い人物というのは、警察の近い人物というのはごく少数で、あとは警察官は袴田さんが犯人だと信じてしまい、で犯人だけれども証拠が足りないから捏造に協力するとかですね、そういうことも多分おそらくあったんではないかというふうに思います。
But I believe that perhaps it was only a very small number of individuals within the police who were either aware of or close to the actual person responsible for the crime. And the other police would have perhaps believed that indeed Mr. Hakamata was responsible for the crime, but that there was not enough evidence for this. So have been involved in this kind of fabrication in order to bring about enough evidence towards who they did believe was the criminal.
Okay, Mr. Nishijima, just want to add something that in the end. So let's keep him a microphone. どうぞ。
袴田さんの今の精神状態は、先ほど秀子さんが言われたようにまだまだ拘束中からの状態が続いて、改善はしていないと。その点に関して若干の付加説明をしておきたいと思います。
I would like to add an initial point in regards to the current mental or psychological situation of Mr. Hakamata. As we've heard from his sister as well, his situation is very much still as if he was still being imprisoned. There has not been significant improvement in his situation, and I would like to share some more about that.
東京拘置所に拘禁中、つまり再審手続きの途中で、彼がどういう精神状態であるかということで、弁護側の方では専門の精神鑑定をしていただきました。
During the time when he was being held in the detention center in Tokyo in regards to the retrial procedures, we had an expert psychological evaluation conducted of him upon the request of his defense team.
彼の精神の状態は心神喪失、つまり 死刑の執行はできないという法律の規定に合致するような精神鑑定が出ました。
And the psychological evaluation which was issued was that he could not be considered, you know, in full sanity according to legal definitions of this, that he was somewhat, you know, separated from reality.
その状態はその後も改善されていないということで、こちらが新たに第二次再審請求をするときも、請求人は岩尾さんは精神活動ができないわけですから、お姉さんが再審請求の請求人に今なってます。
And so we can see that there has not been an improvement of his situation. Also, based on this psychological evaluation, it was decided that Mr. Hakamata himself could not submit the request for the retrial as well. Therefore, his sister submitted this request on his behalf because of his psychological state.
です。我々はお姉さんから弁護人選任届をもらって、それで裁判所に第二次再審請求を起こして、それで弁護活動を続けている、そういう変則的な状態になっています。
So we can see there is this somewhat indirect situation where we, as the legal team, are requesting, are receiving the request from his sister, and then it is this which we are submitting in regards to appealing for the second retrial and so on. So this is the situation that we are in now.
とりあえずコメントです。
はい、ありがとうございます。Okay, thank you very much. Okay, I think we are running out of time. We have a little bit of extension.And please note that Mr. Hakamada is now 85 years old. He was arrested at the age of 30. So he spent 48 years until the age of 78 in the prison, most of which was as a death convict. The conviction was proven, then he is entitled to receive 12,500 yen, up to 12,500 yen, about $120 a day for compensation from the government, which makes him entitled to receive up to about 200 million yen, 2億円, 約2億円. Do you think it's enough for what happened? That's up for you to think about. Anyway, well, thank you very much, and as a tradition, we have a guest membership for three speakers today. And also, we love to have Mr. Hakamata-san. Hirako-san, Iwao-san はまだ健康状態的にはあれですか、コロナが落ち着いてきたりすればまたこちらに来ていただくことは可能な状態なんですか？コロナが終われば健康状態としてはもう東京まで出てきて、ここでまたお話しいただくこともそのうち可能なんでしょうか？
例えば自分の言いたいことは言いますが、
はいはい、
質問の要点はもう完全にピントン狂ってます。
それはもう、はい。
He would be able to, even if he were physically able to come here, he might be able to say what he would like to share, but he would not be able to, you know, respond to questions.
Yeah, but we still love to have him if our health situation permits. So thank you very much for coming, and I'll present our three speakers the 1-year guest membership. Thank you. Thank you for coming to the press conference.